Well, I'm over here in Wyoming. I'll give you a mile marker in a minute. But I figured I'd get a picture of all them rain clouds out there. And I like that one over there with a streak of light showing through. Display. I haven't seen any lightning yet, but by the way, my speedometer is working. It's been working ever since I loaded the Pratt valves. So, yeah, the rain really looks like it's coming down over there. Light that comes across the sky there. Looks like just to where it hits the ground, looks like some heavy rain coming down over there on the left of it. Alright. Love you, honey. Talk to you later. There I go, signing off like it's a phone call again. Love you. Bye. I just went through Salt Lake, and getting ready to cross the desert part of Utah over here. The sign said gusty winds until 8 p.m. tonight, and the winds are at 40 miles an hour. I'm on Interstate 80. Heading west. And I don't know if you can see. Let me see if I can make this camera so it'll zoom. I don't know if that's zooming. There we go. Zooming. See all the dust blowing out there? Dust around, and I'm gonna have fun driving through it. Luckily my load is only 4 feet tall, so I'm not all the way up there at 13 feet 6 inches. We're probably gonna end up seeing some trucks that have turned over from the wind, and I will try to capture them on the video. That's a lot of wind blowing through that canyon over there. And so, I might as well put the camera down and pay attention to my driving. I love you, honeybee. Talk to you later. Bye. I don't know how true that is. equipment in there just to see how buoyant I felt. But, yeah, that's just on the outskirts of Salt Lake City, Utah. Nice lake. Got some train activity going on over there. He's hauling coal. That train's taking all them car loads of coal. Probably taking them out to the GE electric plant out there in California. Coal is one of the number one things they use for creating electricity. Pretty soon they won't be doing coal, burning coal to make electricity anymore. There will be all them big wind fields. Oh, look at the Great Lakes. It's Great Salt Lake. What's this lady doing? I just gave her hair a blowjob. Yeah, you can see the train down here with all them loads of all that coal. That coal is gonna go get burned to create electricity. Alright, well, it's not as windy as it was back there. I am now entering Thule County, Utah. Now I'm gonna have a race with that train. See who gets to California first. Toot toot, Mr. Engineer. Alright, there's a lot of gold mines up there. A lot of people got their own gold mine. Don't get caught. Ah, here comes the wind again. Nice heavy wind. Alright, I need to put my camera away. Love you, honeybee. Talk to you later. Just turn the camera back on for a minute so we can see this sign. Gusty winds, 40 mile per hour until 8 p.m. Alright, back to turning the camera off. Bye. Yeah, here I go again, making some more video. Big white pile. That's a lot of salt. They pull that out of the salt lakes. It's probably table salt and the salt they use for melting the ice and the salt that they use for giving it to the cattle and, you know, they make salt licks. They get a lot of salt out of that lake. What they do is they drain the lake into, you know, like sections like this, and then they turn it off and they let the water evaporate, and what's left is all that salt. They scrape it up. Scrape it up and do things with it. Naturally. Oh well. See, there's one of the sections that they, there's one right here. They come out here with tractors and scrape it all up, and that waterway that's right behind that salt right there, that's a gated salt collection. There's another one. It's all fenced off. They flood it, and then they go in there with plows and plow all that salt up. And they get a lot of salt out of there. Probably why there ain't no fish in the salt lake. You can see the sections. They got sections off over there that they fill full of water. Then they let the water evaporate and it leaves nothing but salt. Oh well. you. Talk to you later. I am 489 miles from Reno, Nevada. Love you, honeybee. Talk to you later. Bye. Okay, I don't know if the camera's going to pick that up, but if you can see that out there, big cloud of dust, you can see how fast it's approaching the freeway. It's approaching the freeway pretty fast. You can't even see the hill that's back there on the other side of it, so I'm about to get hit with a nice blast of wind. Back out. A minute ago, you could see straight through here. Now, got a solid wall of white dust. And I can feel the wind picking up from the outer edges. Windstream here any second. Whoa! Yeah, nice windstream. Alright, I went through it. Damn it. Okay. Well, there it is back there. I'm up here now, I can see straight ahead. Coming up to Knowles, K-N-O-L-L-S, Utah, exit 41, at mile marker 42, which means I got 42 miles till I get to Nevada. So I'll talk to you later, honeybee. Love you. Bye.